Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I have something really special and exciting. I've never tried this brand before. I'm also not sponsored by them. I bought these with my own money. I went to different stores. I went online to find the cheapest. These are affordable makeup. I've seen this like around everywhere in the UK. And I've never tried them because I was very skeptical about it. But I got the nerves and the courage to go and buy them and try them out for you guys. So this is my first ever impression video with this brand, and drum rolls please. It is the W7 makeup range. I've got the whole thing on. I'm moving from foundation, highlighter, eyeshadow, contour, lipstick, everything, the whole shebang. Want to know what I think about this product and how it worked on my face? Then please keep on watching. So I'm taking the Perfection Pore Minimizer Primer. It feels very soft. Very silicone-y, that's for sure. It has that, it has like that really like plastic kind of smell. Next, I'll be using the foundation, which is Genesis Feather Light Foundation in the color True Beige. It says shake before using it, so can you hear that? It's very watery. Okay, so let's see what this would turn out to be like. Okay, so you can see that. You see that? It's super, super watery. So, let's see what it looks like on the skin. This flat brush here to blend the foundation out. Let's see what it looks like with the foundation with the brush this side and the sponge on the other side. So the color is not too bad. Maybe it's not too dark. It's I don't like it with the brush because it's giving me really streaks, like I can see a lot of streaks, so I am not doing it with the brush. I'm gonna use my Primark blender. It's like the sponge is sucking all of the foundation in. Okay, this is not a full coverage foundation, I can tell you that for sure. And I think I'm gonna have to go in once more because, yeah, it's not really there. It's like the sponge drank it all up because it turned out looking like water. So let me put a little bit more. Okay, the buildup is not bad. It's not looking cakey. It's looking almost like skin. Don't know how I feel about this foundation. It's not full coverage. It's just like light to medium coverage. I preferably wanted the full coverage one, but there was nothing in stock. Oh, by the way, I got the foundation from B&M. They do stock this brand there, and yeah, I believe this was like £3 for the foundation. So however, the finish of it is matte. It's not shimmering anywhere. It's just a matte cover. Not bad. I didn't like it the first layer. I just thought it wasn't great but the first time, and I just went in twice to build it up, and it looks fine. It came through in the end. Next, I'm taking the W7 Saved by the Gel Super Gel Concealer in the shade, it doesn't say. Oh, Fair. In the shade Fair. I bought this concealer because B&M doesn't have all of it. So I got this concealer in, where did I get it? Fragrance Direct Online. So they had a lot of this one in stock. Just like so, this is what it looks like. Okay guys, while I'm sitting here, this foundation actually oxidizes. I'm not joking, my face is quite dark than my neck. Can you see the difference? So embarrassing. Right, let's try this. This is a very weird applicator, but we'll see. And I believe this was not expensive at all. It was about £2, something like that. Fragrance Direct has a offer going on, so if you buy 5, you get a you get 1 for free. Where is it? It didn't do nothing. I think the sponge is not working very well for me. It's soaking everything up. Let's go with the brush instead. I'm gonna go in with my real techniques and just put this through. Okay, it's working much better than the beauty blender or the sponge. It's not bad. I wish I bought the red concealer to like the color corrector, but they ran out of stock. Let me go in again. I'm not really feeling this. I like a bit more coverage because I'm not feeling the coverage on this one just yet. So let's see. I'm not giving up on it. I'm still giving it a chance. Not bad. Not bad. I like the second time. Building up on these is not bad at all. But for those who doesn't like building up on concealer, that's fine. You don't have to. You can stay with the light concealer. Next, I'm taking the Twist and Shape, W7 Twist and Shape eyebrow in the color brown. So this is what it looks like. Packaging, very plastic, very lightweight, so... But hey, let's see, it's more to do with the product than the packaging, right? I'm feeling the eyebrows. It's not bad. Let's take the stubby side and blend everything out. Okay. It's not working well with the blending, that's for sure. But we'll do our best. Actually, I take it back. It's working well. It's working really, really well. I like it. Got these two. This is the contour stick and this is the contour palette. This is the cream one. They're both cream, so I don't know which color to go for. You know what? I'll do half and half. So this face will be the palette, this face will be the stick. So let's see how that works out. Oh, I didn't tell you. I've got this in the color medium, I think. Yes, this is medium. They're both medium. Let's do this. That's the highlight part for the stick. And I'm gonna take this color here. Yeah, it doesn't say what color they are. I'm gonna take this color here. Ooh, it's thick. Definitely thick. I'm gonna use my finger because I don't seem to have a brush anywhere. I'm gonna take the lightest one to highlight, so actually, no, I'll take my finger. Ooh, that's bright. I'm gonna look so funny. So right off the bat, the contour stick, the highlighter part is a little too yellow side, and the palette here is more on the pastely white side, as I can tell. Right, let's start blending this out. The blending is not bad. This has definitely highlighted, for sure. Okay. What I'm noticing, this side, the creamier one than the stick, the creamy one seems to be sticking on quite well than the stick. It seems to be fading away, but the creamy palette is holding on very nicely. It's time to chisel this cheekbones of mine. Okay. On camera, it's still like nicely bronzed out, but here, I can't see anything. Oh my god, a ghost. Let's try this side. Oh, the creamy side is much better. I look crazy. So this side is the stick and this side is the palette. I prefer the palette size more. Not so, actually, on camera, the stick side, the highlight looks very, like, calming than this. This one looks a little too white. Maybe I chose the wrong color. I should have gone for the more yellower one, right? Yeah. But the Banana Dream Loose Powder. Ooh! I'm gonna take the sponge. Oh my god! I should have checked that. I put so much. Okay, let's settle this down a bit. Okay. I look crazy now. I like it. I will let that bake for a bit. I'm taking the Honolulu bronzer. I believe this is trying to be a dupe of something. By the way, guys, I don't know all the pricing on top of my head. I'm gonna put everything down below for you guys to know. Oh, it comes with a little applicator. That's cute. Ooh, it's soft. I'm gonna take this angled, fluffy contour brush. Put that in there. Let's see. What have I done? I put a little too much, did I? Shit. It's okay. We will try and fix this. Oh my god, it's so pigmented. I should have not gone in so hard on the brush. Okay, forehead not too bad, but the cheeks. Fix this. No, it's too much. It's too much. No, I don't mind the forehead, but this bronzer is a bit much. No, 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 no. Let's carry on. I'll just light hand this time. Let's do it that way. And this is not too bad. And this side. Oh my god. This side looks pretty good. This side, not so good. And that one. Let's try and fix this. Get the fluffy brush out. Let's clean up the baking. I'm loving this side. I'm not loving this one. I don't know what happened here. You know, people make mistakes. It's fine. Base is prepped. Now, I am taking this palette right here, the number 7 Delicious palette. And doesn't it remind you? Oops. Doesn't it remind you of something? Or a palette particularly? I thought so too. So it comes with this brush, double-ended brush right here. It's got the fluffy side, it's very soft. And it's got this little like hard side. So this one does not come with a name or whatsoever. The cover did not come with a name either. I'm gonna swatch everything by the end of the video to show you what these are all like. I could do it in the end of the video or in between. I'll see. Let me take a fluffy blending brush and I'm gonna go with this first color right here. Good thing it comes with a mirror, so. Ooh! Very powdery. Very, very powdery. Can't see anything with this transition color. Maybe I should change transition color. I'm gonna, instead of this, I can't see anything on my skin, so I'm gonna take this too, probably this one. Is it showing up? Maybe if I build on it. Yeah, it's there all right. It's just blending in with my skin. Same blending brush, I'm taking this pinkier shade right here. That one's not too bad. Just blend that all through. Not bad. So I'm taking the brush from the palette, this color right here. I'm gonna put it over here. I have to keep going in to build it up. It's pigmented though. For a cheap palette, it's not bad. Well, original price was £10. I just got it cheaper from different places where they sell them. Okay, I'm not comfortable with this brush. I like it, but I'm not comfortable because it's so tiny. I don't feel like my hand is like all cramping up in here. But it's really good though. I'm quite impressed. Next, I'm taking this color right here and I'm gonna put it right in here. Ooh, this one's pigmented. Let's blend it all out. I don't know how this happened, but it looks pretty cool. I'll work with that. I'm going to take the concealer and conceal my inner corners. I'm gonna take the brush and use the other end just to there we go. Next, I'm taking this color right here. Ooh, this is amazing. Taking that color once more. With that same color, I'm just gonna put in my bottom lash line. Next, I'm gonna go in with mascara, but this one came with a 2-pack. So this one has the mascara and the liner, and this mascara is called Big Lash Mascara. This is what the eyeliner looks like. I didn't get a liquid liner, guys, so I'm gonna just use this as my liner. So let's see how it goes. Alright, that's liner done. Let's see what the mascara is like. Ooh. That's the wand. Can you see? Okay. Right off the bat, mascara is okay. It's just a normal mascara. I am taking the Candy Blush, and this is the color Galastic. Ooh, this comes in a mirror. Ooh, this is pigmented. So guys, I'm very, very excited to try this next product. I saw that it got released on the website and it was also in Fragrance Direct. So, this is the Beam Me Up Illuminator. This is supposed to be like the iconic London, everything like that. Everyone's doing this illuminator like drops and whatnot. So let's see what this is like. I got this in the color Dynamite. This actually looks quite big than the iconic London. Ooh, that's thick. Okay, so this sucky thing is not working, so I'm gonna have to just... Ooh, is it stuck? So let's try it with the hands. Okay, a lot of swatches here. So my last videos that when you guys watched, I did the test with Makeup Revolution Illuminator and the Iconic next to it. So let's see about this. So this one has the same kind of thing. Ooh, this is thick. Okay. Oh wow, I actually like how this blends out. That blend out very nicely. Let's see what it's like on the face. Also guys, just a little update. I'm loving this banana powder. It's so smooth. I'm loving it. Three dots just like so. I'm gonna take the blender. Okay, blender's not so good. I'm gonna use my hands. Ooh, it's better by hands than the blender. Ooh, I like that. What I can see here is not as striking as the Makeup Revolution. Yes, actually, it's not as striking as the Makeup Revolution or the Iconic London. They come out a little more metallic now. However, this looks like an inner glow kind of thing, you see? What I've just noticed that with this, you gotta work fast because when it dries, it just sticks down. Oops. It's not even moving the makeup, which is very good. Ooh. I got the Glow Commotion. Okay, now I got this in the pound shop for a pound. Can you believe that? They were stocking this. And I got the number 7. Sorry, it's so dirty. I've been swatching. I got the strobe time called Vivid Glow. So I'm gonna take this one. Okay, can you see how shimmery that is? Yeah, there you go. It's glowing. And yet, it's still glowing. Okay. Ooh. Okay, and we got this one. So this is the color right here. So you can use this as a shimmer, highlighter, and a shadow as well. So you can do it. We can do it with all of these. You just gotta add mineral water or, you know, wet your brush and pop it on and boom, it's there. Or put concealer and it's there. Okay, so I'm gonna use this on this side and I'll use the strobing ones on this side. Swivel it around. Oh, I didn't even swatch this. Let's swatch this. Ooh, do you look at that? 1 pound, guys. 1 pound. Oh my God. Are you freaking kidding me right now? This is 1 pound, guys. Wow. Ooh. Oh. I don't see any difference. They are both equally as good. Wow. I found out that I went into the website and I saw that they also do lashes. Wispy lashes. Just my kind. So I'm gonna pop this on and I'll be right back. Oh my God. These lashes. They are absolutely amazing! Oh my God! They're soft, they're comfortable. They're not, you can't feel like they're, like you have anything on. It's just, oh my God, it's amazing! Who would have thought, right? So for the finale piece, guys, I came across these. Now, I got these in B&M, I believe. I don't know what the prices exactly are, but I can always find out for you. These are the matte lipsticks. So they're called Mega Matte Lips. So I believe this color is nude. This one is Two Bob, it's called. This is called Billionaire. And the last nude I've picked up is called Filthy Rich. Don't these remind you of something? This packaging. I picked up the matte lip called Maria right here. So this red one's calling my name. It's called Vinto. Is it Vinto? Yes. Vinto Tinto. Is Billionaire. Very subtle. Very orange. Ooh. I like this. Oh, I didn't test if it's kiss proof. Nope. Not kiss proof at all. But perfect to take access of though. Next one is called Mega. Okay, this is coming off a little streaky. Can you tell? This is Two Bob. Ooh, I like this. Okay, so now I'm gonna try the other two colors. Ooh! What the hell? What the hell's that? Okay. That was weird. Alright. We're out of the bag, guys. This feels very drying. The other ones felt very, like, it felt soft and moisturizing. This one, however, is very drying. I don't know, maybe the formula because it's too thick. And it's kind of streaky. I don't like this. I'm sorry. This is not for me. Okay, now it's the red one. I'm hoping this is good. Okay, not streaky. It's not like the pink one for sure. Obsessed. Absolutely obsessed. This is my favorite. This is the perfect red. I've been looking for this red forever. Like forever. Oh, this is perfect. And no streaks, guys. And this is without a liner. So it's dried down a little bit. Let's see. Let's test this if it's kiss proof. Almost. Okay guys, so my final thoughts about this, I'm not mad at it. I'm actually not mad at it. I love how this look turned out. This eye look is amazing. So it's affordable. This makeup is affordable. It's good. There are some hits and misses. So for example, this lipstick, no. Not having it. I think I'm gonna chuck that straight in the bin. I'm not having that one. This mascara, it's just like every other normal mascara. So yeah, everything else I love. I like it. The only thing I don't like is this part of the face. I don't like how this came out. It didn't turn out great. I don't know what happened there. I don't know. This however turned out amazing, so I don't know. People make mistakes, I guess. Everything else is good. The eyelashes, amazing. Definitely gonna buy some more. This palette, worth it. Absolutely worth it. Lipstick, amazing. Highlighter, amazing. I love all of these products. Foundation, actually, it's not that bad now. Earlier, it was a little too dark, but it looks okay now. Concealer. It's okay. It's not the best concealer, but it's good. It's good. It covers my dark circles. So yeah. So guys, thank you so much for stopping by, and I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed my point of view and trying this makeup out and the look, how it turned out. So yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching this video, and stay tuned for the next one. Bye.